Holding Back the Tide by Nick Warburton, with Paul Ritter, Kate Duchêne and Ronald Pickup.
My Aunt Elizabeth had a large rambling house in Yorkshire, a little seaside town called Breck Howe. When she died, she left the house to me. I don't know why, I'd hardly seen her since I was a child. I thought, well, I can sell it. This is very timely, sell it. I don't even have to go there. But Clare had other ideas.
We ought to, though, don't you think?
I don't see what difference it'll make.
To pay our respects. Poor Aunt Elizabeth.
Well, she won't be there. Anyway, you never knew Aunt Elizabeth.
That's not the point.
I hardly knew her myself.
It was her home, though, poor soul. And anyway...
What?
A day or two on the coast. It'll be different, won't it?
So we went, by train, on a couple of advance saver tickets. Ah, here's one now. Taxi!
Can you take us to Ash Wilfred Cliff?
Up to a point.
It's what the road's called.
I know.
It's on the cliff somewhere?
It is.
A row of houses?
The one we once called Vaugarth.
Vaugarth?
Yes, V-A-U-X.
No.
No?
No, not on Ash Wilfred Cliff. There's no Vaugarths up there.
But...
Thank you. We'll see for ourselves. Get in, Richard.
Ten minutes later, the taxi came to a halt at the bottom of a steep footpath.
Up there.
A winding footpath.
Is there no road up?
This is as close as you'll get on wheels.
Oh.
Okay, lovely. Thanks very much. So we had to walk the last bit, up a zigzag path. Eventually, we came to a row of tall houses behind a dark hedge.
There. Look. On that gate. Vaugarth.
She said it wasn't here.
The first in the row. Standing on its own like a sentry box.
It's old, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not straight, Clare. Looks to me as if it's leaning.
Still. Aunt Elizabeth's house. Poor old thing.
The living room was upstairs, dusty and undisturbed.
Oh, it overlooks the sea.
A faded armchair, a glass-fronted cabinet full of little jugs, a small tapestry footstool with a tin on it.
Ooh! Biscuits!
Don't eat them! Oh, Clare, they must be at least 2 months old.
They're biscuits, Richard.
All this dust about them.
Biscuits don't go off.
A bay window overlooked the sea. Well, there's an island, look.
Great Hoggard, according to the map. I wonder if there's a lesser Hoggard.
No sign of one.
And you've never been here?
No.
Not once? Not when you were little?
No, I hardly ever saw Aunt Elizabeth. I mean, she came to stay once or twice when I was about 9. I can't remember much. She was quiet and powdery, talcum powdery.
Well... She remembered you.
Yes, obviously.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Hmm.
We do have to sell it, I suppose.
We agreed we would.
But we hadn't seen it then.
There was a track up from the beach once. Were you aware?
There was a little man standing just outside on the landing.
It slipped away, though.
A dark suit with a watch chain.
I'm sorry, I didn't realise that...
Yes. You thought you were on your own.
We did.
He studied us through round glasses. First Clare, then me.
May I ask...
Yes?
Yeah, I don't actually know you.
Well, no.
I don't even know if you're supposed to be here.
Of course. I'm Richard Wells. This is Clare.
Clare.
I see.
We're the new owners.
Yes.
The house belonged to my aunt, Miss Hearn. She left it to me.
So she did. Well, shut the window, Richard, if you don't mind. Yes, so, you have a key?
Yes, from the agent.
Oh, Abbott and Meadows?
Yes, and you're...
What?
With them, are you? I mean, they've sent you, have they?
Abbott and Meadows?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I was expecting you. I heard you on the stairs and I thought, that'll be them.
It was.
Yes, we came up the path.
The zig-zag?
Yes, the taxi driver had never heard of Vogarth.
You... Vogarth?
Yes.
I haven't. I don't know where that is.
But...
This is Vosgarth.
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 But spelt V-A-U-X.
Yes. Vosgarth. There is no Vogarth in Breck Howe, unless it's in Newtown.
Oh, isn't this Newtown?
Good heavens, no. Once you cross the walls, you're in Old Town.
The walls?
Medieval town wall. Old Town is completely different.
Is it?
Yeah, Newtown has no history or character. Here, we have a castle.
Lovely.
He stood for a moment, blinking at us.
Has... anyone spoken to you about the best way to proceed? Now you've inherited Vosgarth. Did Abbott say anything, or Meadows?
No. We're calling later to confirm our plans. We thought we'd take a look first.
Well, I can help you with that.
With?
Your plans.
Well, we've already...
I had a meeting with Mr. Meadows this morning, in fact, and he's strongly of the opinion... that you should keep the property.
Oh?
Hang on to it. Don't sell.
No.
It's a bad time to sell. Let it.
Let it?
We at Upperton Meadows will handle all that. The rental side of things, the maintenance...
So we'd just take over a floor, would we?
No.
No?
Absolutely not. The worst thing you could do.
Why?
You must stay where you are. Which is...
Sorry.
Sorry. Well, splendid. Look at you. Yes, yes. You stay there in Surrey and we'll look after Vosgarth for you.
No, I'm not so sure.
No, nor am I. I've rather taken to it.
No, no, I didn't mean... would you mind?
You, what?
Mr...
Hector?
Hector.
Mr... Hector.
Would you mind, Mr. Hector? I need to have a little word, if that's all right.
Well, of course, sir.
In private.
Yes, yes, yes. I'll shut the door.
Thank you. With my wife, I mean, on our own.
I see. In that case, I'll be just outside on the landing.
Clare.
We could take over a floor, Richard. Don't you think?
I'm not sure that would work for us.
Why not?
Well, we said we'd sell.
But Mr. What's-his-name says don't.
But it's our decision, and I think we should stick to selling, as things are.
As things are?
Yes.
How are they?
A bit tricky at the moment, to be honest.
What does that mean?
I think... well, I'm fairly sure we'd need the money from selling the house. In fact, it's quite timely.
Why? Why is it... timely, Richard.
I've been made redundant.
Redundant?
Yes.
You mean
they've let me go. They let me go. I don't work at Larrington's anymore. I've been meaning to tell you.
But you haven't, have you?
Not quite, no.
Not quite? Not at all? Not a whisper? I don't believe this.
I'm sorry.
I took unpaid leave to come up here all this time. Sacked?
Well, not sacked, exactly.
And you don't say a word. I'm not included.
But it's not been easy, finding the right moment.
It's what you're supposed to do, Richard. You're supposed to talk to me.
Well, there was more to be said on that matter, clearly. And the estate agent was still waiting, so I popped outside to the landing.
Mr. Hector, I think we might need a moment or two more.
Only he wasn't there.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.